Doing out there, huh? Captain Boomer. How'd you get that voice going like what's-his-name, huh? Remember that? Ow, Wolfman Jack, baby. Here we are coming to you from downtown Hollywood. Yeah, baby. Ah, Wolfman Jack. Ah, ooh, yeah, baby. Remember Wolfman Jack? Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Wolfman. He'd be cool. Mm-hmm. He'd be in that movie, you know, American Spaghetti. Yeah, they're right. And he'd be eating on a popsicle, you know what I'm saying? Hey, Wolfman Jack. Actually, it's not Wolfman Jack. It's just me, Captain Boomer. How you guys doing? Coming to you live from the Twin Cities area, where I'm going to be taking over the airways here. I'm going to give myself, I figure in 5-10 years. Well, depends on Mr. Orange, you know, my agent. We're going to be, we're going to be at the top of the charts. Oh, Tommy Bernard and all those guys, they better get out of town because they... I'm going to blow them out of the water. Oh, yeah. No problem here. Anyway, all right. Okay. Today we're going to be playing a little bit of John Lennon's Imagine. We're going to be playing a triple shot of John Lennon. If you want to stay tuned, that'd be just great. I would love for you to be on board and stay on board for a little while here. We'll be trying to do an hour show today. It's kind of hard sometimes because, I kind of run out of things to say sometimes. But the thing is, if you come up with more bullshit and crap and stuff, that's just it. That's the trick, see, I think. It's just to come up with more bullshit that people... Well, here it is right here. I'm going to go back to this. This is out of The Onion. If you're familiar with The Onion, and The Onion reports, report, nobody fucking cares. There you go. Nobody fucking cares. That kind of puts it in a nutshell, don't it? And there's a lot of truth in that. It's sad, but it's true. Nobody fucking cares, right, guys? You bet. You're kind of slow on the draw there. What the hell? God, I love this. I don't know why I do it. I mean, I know why I do it, but what am I thinking about? How do I? I mean, it'll come back to me. Anyway, this show is entitled, you guys remember it? Bosco is versing Ovaltine today. Now, I don't know which you prefer, but we're going to have my people's going to be doing a survey out there and stuff. You can go online here and do our survey. But I got a feeling old Bosco's gonna pull this one out. I like them both, I guess, but I think Bosco's gonna pull this one out. And don't you worry, gang, we will keep you updated on the results of this contest or whatever, but I'm telling you, this is international news. Just like most of the shit they got on for real on news. But anyways, this is Bosco is versing Ovaltine today. And so stay tuned and you will check out the results. That's right. And you know what else? I'll tell you one thing right here. I got me a GAD. I got a DD-214. I got me a Section 8. I got me a war medal. He is Captain Boomer. I am large and in charge. And he's also pretty, I am cuckoo. All right, we have, that's a new sound effect that I added from when we get some cuckoo shit on. And boy, I'm telling you, there is a lot of cuckoo shit out in the world, isn't there? There is a lot of cuckoo shit. I mean, I don't know if the world's ever been so effed up, so Just plain cuckoo. There you go. It's a cuckoo world. Yes, it is. Okay, we're going to go. Let's get our plug out for military appreciation. Captain Boomer has a military appreciation station, always has been and always will be. Thank you guys and gals out there. Thank you lifers out there. We're making a career out of the military. God bless you guys, wherever you're stationed. Have a great hump day. And for anybody listening out there, just nobody's listening, you fucking idiot. It is hump day, so go out and find something to hump, okay? It doesn't matter. Just find something to hump, okay? All right. Yeah, then you can really have and call yourself, you really had a hump day, all right? But try to keep it as clean as you can, all right? Try to run a clean show here. Anyway, we're going to be jumping into a little bit of... And we're going to be talking about Donnie's wall, as usual, because there again... And Donnie said, and it just made, it's just, I don't know where these Democrats, I really don't believe they have much common sense. Donnie explained it and pretty much just, you know, I think about a third grader could understand what he was saying. The problem does not start with the United States. The problem starts with Mexico. Okay, you have a whole country in between Central America and our U.S. border, okay? Are you with me? All right. Now, why is it our problem? Why isn't it Mexico? The problem starts with people down below Mexico wanting to come through their country and come into ours. Now you follow me? This is what Donnie was saying. He wants Mexico to step up and do something. Here it is. Mexico should be building or having some kind of border security down there. I don't have the map in front of me, gang. I don't know what country, Honduras or Guatemala, whatever country is borders Mexico. That's where the freaking border starts right there. That's where the control starts. That's where either a semi-wall or whatever. And Mexico foots the bill, right? That's what Donnie's been saying here. And it's just common sense. It's not our responsibility. It's Mexico's. They're sitting there laughing their ass off. Hell, yeah, we'll let them come through our country for a while, have a caravan and all that shit, but they're going to end up being, you know, good U.S. of A. Anyway, so we'll just let them come through. Bullshit. Anyway. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Bravo, he says. I like that guy. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to have a live audience one day. Yeah, I come pack them into my little studio here. It's about 8 by 10, I think it is. Yeah, it's my little studio, 8 by 10. So you guys got a chance to get up and personal with the old captain here when you win tickets to come on into my studio. Oh, heck yeah. That's the only way I'd have it. I'm getting a big kiss out to my cousin Susie Q. She's been feeling under the weather. Sorry, dear. I hope you're feeling better. And all that other stuff. Take care of that eye, and she got a black eye, you know, Cousin Sue. Yeah, she fell down, and yeah. Anyway, I love you, Sue. There you go, babe. Pucker up, babe. A triple pucker upper kisser for my Cousin Sue down in the Stillwater area. Yeah. Uh-oh. Here they come. Hi, guys. That's Officer Trudy and Muldoon from Car 54. Where are you? Thank you, guys. No, I don't want any donuts. No. Thanks anyway. All right, Trudy, yeah. Lay off those triple glaze with, you know, it's got 4 pounds of sprinkles on them. Come on. You're smarter than that. Don't you guys got to take any kind of physical kind of tests? At least like once or twice a year? I mean, you know, like bend over and try to touch your toes at least or something? No? Why, hell, no wonder. Get out of here. I'll talk to you guys later. See ya. There they go. Officer Tootie and Muldoon. Let's just zap right in here, guys, okay? We're going to zap on in and try to play some. We're going to be doing a little bit of John Lennon. Let's do a little John Lennon. Show you off the Imagine. if I can get it. Here we go.
You know how hard it can be.